Hi everyone, it's Darlene. Welcome back for another card video. Today's card is a galaxy card. I'm using this You're a Star sentiment by Simon Says Stamp and My Star Dies by Stampin' Up, but you can use any star dies. I'm gonna start with a piece of Strathmore 90 pound watercolor paper. I have these artist brushes by Ranger and I'm gonna use the half inch brush to start. And these are the distress ink colors I'm using. I've got Twisted Citron, Picked Raspberry, Salty Ocean, and Wilted Violet. I'm gonna put a little bit on my craft mat of each one. And then I have a jar of water, and the first thing I'm gonna do is spritz my cardstock so it's nice and moist, so when the color hits it, it'll start blending. So I just like to poke it with a paper piercer to hold it down because it is gonna curl up a little bit. It does stop curling after a little bit and I won't need to do that anymore, but you could also tape it to your craft mat if you want to. I'm just a little too lazy to do that. All right, so now I'm gonna work from light to dark, and you can see I'm just sort of putting patches of color here and there. It really doesn't matter because I'm gonna cover a lot of it with black, so you're not really gonna see the lines between the colors. I just wanna make sure that you don't put like the purple and the Twisted Citron too close to each other because it will kind of turn a little muddy, so you don't wanna overlap those too much. But you know, you could put the blue on top of the pink on top of the blue, the pink on top of the Twisted Citron. So you shouldn't have much problem with any of these colors. The next thing I'm gonna do is take this number 9 brush, and I'm just gonna use some water to tap some just little bits of water, mostly over the lines between the colors. And what this is gonna do as I drop this water is the water's gonna plume out into a really kind of pretty water stain, and I'll blend these colors together a little bit, but more just add some variation for when I put the black on top. And you wanna do this while your cardstock is still wet, and that's what's causing the water to kind of spread out. So you can see up close here how pretty it is when you add those water drops. All right, the next thing I'm gonna do is dry this completely. So before you move on to actually adding the black, you wanna make sure that everything is completely dry. So I did this pretty quickly, but you can see as it dries, you're gonna get some pretty kind of dark water staining, which is kind of nice. Okay, so it kind of looks like a mess, but now we're gonna add the black set over it. So I'm gonna put some of that on my craft mat, and I'm going to go back to my half inch brush. And I added some here and I zoomed in so you could see what I'm doing. But at this stage in the game, I'm really just adding a light coat of this black soot. So you can see I just grabbed some more water, and so I'm really just covering up most of the area. I'm using a varied motion, so sometimes circles, sometimes lines, and I'm not gonna leave too much that's not covered. I'm especially focusing on covering the lines between the colors. So I don't wanna leave an area open that's half yellow, half pink. So I'm gonna really try to separate these colors. And now I'm gonna speed it up quite a bit. And it turns out that I'm gonna end up focusing, this piece is rather large, I think it's more like a 5x7. And I'm gonna be cutting a much smaller area, which is why I made it such a big piece of paper so I can kind of pick the nicest area. But it's kind of a large area, so I'm really gonna focus more on the left-hand side. So you can see some of my areas are dark black and some of them are lighter. So I am trying to vary the amount of color that I use, but for the most part, I'm just trying to get the areas covered so I could see where I'm working. So you see I had a lot of that yellow or Twisted Citron area open, and so I decided it was a little bit too much color. The first time, every time you do this kind of galaxy thing, it's gonna come out completely different. So the first time I did this, it came out totally different, not nearly as colorful as I'm making this one. I'm not sure which one I like better. I think they both look good. So if you end up covering more of the color, that's fine. This time I decided to try leaving some of it completely open. All right, now, once I get kind of my light coat of the black, I'm gonna refresh my black soot on my craft mat, and I'm taking a smaller brush, this is a number 4 brush, and I want there to be some really dark areas. And so I'm taking just not that much water and some of this black soot, and I'm dropping it mostly on the edges of where the first coat of the black ended. So kind of right by the color. And this is just going to add sort of a dimension to this thing to make it look like it's a bunch of sort of spacey clouds, I guess you could say. So I'm going to drop a bunch of this color, and you can see that my cardstock was still a little bit damp because this dark is pluming out a little bit. Now, once I get kind of those dark areas put in there, I'm going to take just a wet brush. This just has water on it, and I'm dipping it into my jar here on the right, and I'm just softening it up just a little bit so I don't have some dark water stains and dark lines. I do want it to be a little bit soft. So maybe where there's a little bit too much color, I'm gonna cover some of it up, and then I'm just gonna kind of blend out those black lines just a little bit more. The next step you could skip, but I really kind of like adding a little bit more color over on top of the black. So blue on top of the blue area. I'm gonna zoom in here. So purple, I'm gonna add to where the purple was. And it's just gonna add a darker version of the colors that are already there so that rather than just having a bunch of black, you have some color mixed in with the black. In fact, I watched a video on creating galaxies, and one of the ones I watched said you should never use black. So I figured when I added a little bit of color on top of it, it would kind of add a little bit of that dark, but still keep the color. So you can see it's really starting to look dimensional once you add these colors in here. All right, now that I've added that extra color, I'm just gonna add just a tiny little bit of water to blend any areas out that I feel like have harsh lines. Now, this is the kind of project where you could just go on and on and on and spend a really long time on this. But at some point you just have to say, okay, I'm done with it. Because even now I'm thinking, oh, I've got too much color. I'm gonna add some water and kind of blend over that with some of the black. But, and you can see now I'm adding some blue, but it's getting kind of muddy, so I'm deciding I'm just gonna quit. All right, I do have another step. I'm using this number 4 brush and mixing it with quite a bit of water. And my cardstock is very damp, and it's important that it's damp here. So I'm gonna drop some of these Gansai Tombi droplets of white, just kind of here and in there. And it's just gonna add even more dimension. So you could totally skip this step. I know I'm kind of making this long, but I'm putting it kind of in the areas where I feel like there's not a lot of variety. So kind of like a thicket, like right here, there's kind of a big gray area. So I'm gonna drop some white in there just to kind of mix it up a little. And then I started adding actually kind of lines of these. So you can see how it just plumes right out as soon as the brush hits the cardstock. And so I'm gonna pick up a bunch and just, you know, kind of tap in a bunch of lines here and there. And it does make it look even more like clouds. So I'm gonna speed this up here and finish this off. And this is going to be pretty much my last step while it's wet. So once I get these white droplets in there, I'm gonna dry the whole thing. And I'm gonna fast forward this quite a bit. I think it took a total of 30 seconds, but you can see how everything just very mutes down once it dries. Before you do splatters, you definitely wanna make sure that it is completely dry, because if it's not dry, then your splatters are gonna plume out. And I want mine to be circles. So I'm just gonna tap it in here. I've got my 1/2-inch brush that's good for tapping. And so I've got plenty of white spots there. All right, now I'm gonna let that dry while I work on the rest of the card. I'm gonna cut my star out of the right side of this cardstock, and I'm measuring how wide it is from the tip to the edge. And then I'm gonna measure that same distance. It's about 1/2 inch. And I'll trim it out so it's equal, so it's centered. And now I'm gonna figure out what the best area of my galaxy is. And once I figure that out, that's where I'm gonna put my star. So I'm gonna draw some lines here and at the bottom, and that's where I need to trim it. So I'll trim it just inside those pencil lines. I'm gonna cover my star cardstock with some ATG tape runner and adhere it to my galaxy. Now I've already cut my sentiment out of some white cardstock, and you can see I kind of randomly cut it off a piece of scratch paper. And I'm just going to secure it into place, the negative. This is going to help me make sure that all my pieces are completely straight, because there are a lot of pieces that cut out of this. So I'm going to put it through the negative. Sorry, my head's in there. And as I press it down, I'm going to grab my paper piercer to kind of poke through the hole. And it's kind of hard when you have a very delicate, thin-lined word like this. So you kind of have to work at it a little bit. But as long as I press it down there until, and I'm gonna keep lifting it up, which is why I put the surgical tape just on the edge so that I could lift it up easily and kind of press it through the negative until it gets to the cardstock, and then I'll just press it down. And to get the glue on there, I'm just putting it on a tweezer and putting some two-way glue on the back. And so now I've got "You're a Star" all finished. I'll take my negative off. And there are a bunch of stars that also cut from this. And so what I did was, rather than putting them back kind of the way they were in the die, I just randomly placed them half on, half off. Some of them are on, some of them are off. These stars around, just to make it a little bit more interesting so that some of them were outside the star. I just used my pick-me-up stick to make it easier and some multimedia matte. I wanted to add a couple of more white gel pen dots because the Gonzai Tombi white did fade a little bit, and that's just the way it goes because it's watercolor. So I'm going in with my gel pen and just randomly putting some dots here and there to make it stand out, so I've got some kind of bright stars in my galaxy. So this is when I started to doubt myself. I grabbed some more black soot because I thought, you know, it's a little too colorful. I've got this green area here and I wish I didn't have it. So I'm gonna drop some more black. And after I did that, I immediately regretted it and wish I hadn't, because now it's kind of a little bit too black. And then I try to cover up some of this part at the bottom here. And since I have this on video, I know what it looked like. I can compare what it looked like before and after, and it looked better before. So I would just leave it when your mind tells you you need to add more. Okay, I have this foil washi tape. You could just add foil paper or just some silver glitter paper or something like that. And so I didn't want the whole thing to show, just about half of it. So I put some tape runner on the back of my star panel, and then I'll kind of hold it over the washi tape. Actually, this isn't washi tape. It's, well, sort of, it's like a sticker. You have to peel off a backing. Anyway, so then I'm gonna peel this off, and I'll put some tape runner on the rest of the watercolor panel. And then I'm gonna place this onto a Hero Arts note card, which is black on the outside and white on the inside. And that is the card for today. So I know it kind of took a long time to have all these steps. You could skip a bunch of these steps. I'm more of a perfectionist, so I just wanted it to be right. And the first version I created of this card actually was very muted. So you could get a bunch of different looks depending on what you're going for and how much time you have. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.